I don't think there's been another Google Home updates or Google Nest updates video that I've been so excited to give you. There are a ton of new features that you've been asking for a long time. Let's go. Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. I'm Brian from Automate Your Life, and today I'm going to take the frustration out of automation by giving you all the newest features, newest capabilities, and even some new products that work with Google Nest, Google Home, and Google Assistant. Let's start with a really easy capability to utilize. Now, you're going to need to link your Google Duo account through your smartphone or through whatever you're carrying, and then you will see a call home button on your device. And I'm going to show you the settings here, but as I hit that, what I get is a video call coming through. Now, on these devices, I can decline or I can accept the video call. Now, this is only really video calling right now. I've tried to enable it on the Google Home and the Google Home Minis, but right now it's not coming through, but I would expect that to turn into an audio call very soon. Now, if you can't get Google Duo calling, it is limited to a few countries. Change your language on your device to English US or your whole account if you can in the assistant settings, and then go into voice and video calling, and you're just seeing that on screen here, but then you can enable it for different smart displays throughout your home, and those devices will receive the call home phone calls. Now, you're also going to be able to obviously utilize the smart displays, especially something like the Nest Hub Max, with video calling and audio calling utilizing that same service. Speaking of that Nest Hub Max, there's a number of new features with the camera on the front, and this is really one of the big reasons that you want to go and upgrade, but I feel the need to show you guys these new features and how they work. Now, facial recognition, as soon as I look at this camera, it recognizes me, and what that does is that gives me the ability to scroll through different components of the main interface. It allows me to get detailed information that is specifically tended towards me. Now, as I'm scrolling through, you're noticing customized music, customized videos, all of those customized components, even events that are tended towards me, are showing up there, and this will continue to get more and more powerful as we go forward. One of the other things that I notice, and I'm going to show you a demo here in a second, but the custom lists capability is actually there and available on devices like the Nest Hub Max, and it is especially powerful on the smart display. So right now you're not going to be able to navigate very well through just the voice interface and then go access those lists on your device, at least not easily. It's there, but it's tough to get at. Now, over here, what you're going to get is this custom list capability. Show me my lists.
You have four lists. There are video ideas, shopping list, guest, and to-do items.
Show me my list called video ideas.
You have three things on that list. There are notes and lists demo, Nest Hub Max review, and Google Nest Hub Max comparison.
So you can see I can actually tap off any of these items on my list if I'd like to remove them. The other thing is, if I want, I can actually tap into any of these lists simply by tapping on them. So you're able to navigate through your lists as a full custom list feature on a smart display now. One absolutely fantastic feature that people have been asking for forever is the ability to move music from one device to the other or one device to a group of speakers. Now, what I'm going to tell you just before I show you this is that it will show up as a cast button on the smart displays. You'll actually have that cast button physically on there and be able to tap that and then go pick something else. I don't have that yet, but I do have the ability to transfer utilizing my voice. So now as the music is actually playing here on my Nest Hub Max, I can request it to transfer over here. So you can see, it doesn't matter what I do with the volume over here, it's not changing the volume. But watch this. Transfer the music to the original speaker.
Okay, I'll play it on original.
Now, I want to stop and talk a little bit about what's coming. Now, I had a video that I put out last week. If you didn't see it, I'll give you the link at the end of this video. But October 15th is a big release date where we're going to see the Pixel 4 and XL, as well as the Nest Mini and a new Nest Wi-Fi system. And I think there's some other products. Again, you'll have to go watch that other video. But what's really big and what's really coming out are upgrades to the Google Assistant. And I still remember Google I/O with just that lady sitting there and giving probably 15 commands in the matter of a minute and having all of those commands accurately answered and moving through her phone with that. And you're going to see this Google Assistant experience get pushed through to a lot of other devices. And this is definitely a hope for myself, but I also see reason that this is going to show up in a number of Android devices. One of the things that Google is doing right now is trying to mandate Android 10 and push that into a lot of latest generation devices. Now, I don't know which devices are going to get this new version of the Google Assistant, but it is definitely coming for the Pixel 4, and we're going to see a huge number of new capabilities showing up very soon. One interesting component of this, I haven't been able to do it because I'm not in the US, but Duplex has started to show up on the Nest Hub Maxes, and I bet it started to show up here. There's been a number of reports of people who've actually been able to make reservations through this device and have the Google Assistant go out and call. So they're not utilizing their phone, they're utilizing the Nest Hub Max. Now, if you do manage to get that to happen for yourself, go ahead, leave that down in the comments below, or come over to our community where you can kind of post those pictures and show us how that's going on. There's a lot of automators that are very interested in the Duplex system and what it's going to be capable of, as well as when they're going to get access to it on these devices. There are some other experiences or capabilities that have been released prior to this October 15th, and a great example of this is actually within the Chrome browser on smartphones, Android smartphones. You're going to see the ability now to fill out things like movie tickets, and that's an easy example. So when you go to the site, you're going to have the ability now, in some cases, to fill out a form utilizing the Google Assistant. So it'll just autofill and have it done as much as they can for that form. You know, we've been talking about this October 15th date a bit, and I will have a video that as soon as possible will be out that talks about what Google did announce in the end at that event. But we also saw an event from Microsoft here very recently, and they had their own version of the Surface Buds, and really they had a ton of Surface products that came out. I don't love the look of the Surface Buds, but the interesting thing about it is it's not only a Cortana-based device, it's actually Google Assistant, Amazon's voice assistant, Siri, all of those voice assistants are capable on this device. A couple things within routines, and some of the differences here that we're going to see, I think this is very positive stuff. So, number one, you see little icons on an Android device here on the ready-made routine. So, I don't know why it took Google years to do that, and if that was in the if that was in the programming hopper and it took that long, it's ridiculous. But once you go inside the routines, you're actually going to find two types of reminders now. It's not just one. And the first reminder is today's reminders. You can ask the Google Assistant on any of these devices to give you today's reminders, but there's also the home reminders. And I don't quite get what this is all about just yet, but you now have this split between the two types of reminders, and I think what it's going to come into is basically a full list for your whole home of all the reminders that people have at any given time. But I don't actually have anything coming out of that when I utilize it in a routine, and I've tried to pass tasks and reminders to people throughout my home. So if you're able to get something out of that component within routines, go ahead, again, leave that down below. One other thing that I don't think we've talked about enough is the amount of privacy controls that Google is now giving you. And you have the ability to make it so that, you know, voice and assistant activity is auto-deleted. Either it 3 months or 18 months are those time frames that they've given us access to. But what we've also heard, and there is also a manual, so you can just go into the application and delete those things manually. But the other thing we've heard is that you're going to be able to actually ask the voice assistant, just like Amazon has done with theirs, to delete history. Now, I haven't seen this roll out just yet, but this is a coming feature that we're expecting on the Google Assistant. Now, one thing that a lot of you haven't seen, unless you've been watching our reviews on the Nest Hub Max, is the support for gestures. Now, it's only on the Nest Hub Max right now, but let me show you here through a demo. As I have an alarm ring, I can go ahead and just use just my hand to actually stop that from continuing to ring. I can also start and stop music by raising my hand. And you're also able to actually stop interactions with the Google Assistant prior to kind of giving it its next command if you accidentally wake it up. What's very powerful about that in a kitchen environment or a very loud environment is you're not yelling at the device anymore. And I do think that this will come out to the Lenovo Smart Display, but we're going to see a delay in that and other Google Assistant enabled devices. So it's not anywhere but here right now, so you're going to have to wait a little. Now, moving on to some of the other applications, Google Photos has gotten quite an update here, and not only can I cast certain albums and certain picture sets to my Nest Hub Max or any smart display or Google Chromecasts, not only can I do that, but now what you're going to see showing up within Google Photos is the ability to curate those photos yourself, the ones that you want to have show up. Within the Google Photos application, you will find very soon, if you don't have it already, the option for photo frames. And once you tap into that, you're going to have the ability to pick which photos are showing up on a smart display. What you'll find inside the Google Photos application is the button right here that you can press to start casting to the device. Now, you can choose by the name and you can see the type of device that you're casting to. Once you've done that, you actually have the ability to start and stop videos as well as pick specific pictures if you'd like to go ahead and cast to the device. So you can see as soon as I tap on a picture, it shows up and it will stay while I pick another picture here. The other amazing thing is you can see it's actually playing a video that I am casting from my phone. It's not even uploaded to Google Photos. It's coming straight from my phone to the device. Now, the other feature you're going to find eventually is as you tap in the menu, you're going to find that photo frames right there.
If you haven't already heard, there's integration for Google Assistant with Xbox, but I think even more important to this is some of the near field communication that we've seen. Now, iOS already has this with some of their latest generation iPhone models. They have near field communication and the ability to set up shortcuts, essentially. So you bring your phone up, you tap on that near field communication sticker, and that will activate a shortcut for you. But what Google is doing is it looks like they're creating specific situations that you're going to be able to use NFC to trigger events. So one of the things is driving mode, and I think this will be very, very powerful. So essentially putting your phone into a holder with that near field communication capability to trigger into Google Assistant's driving mode. And this is something that will come obviously with the Pixel 4, but we're going to see it again back up into other devices like the Pixel 3a or 3. Now, on that note is something called action blocks. And we talked about shortcuts a little bit from iOS, but Google really hasn't had a response, and people use Tasker quite a bit to get things to happen within Android. Now, what Google is doing is creating action blocks, which was intended more for people who struggle hearing, seeing, or reading in general to kind of create these shortcuts for Google Assistant so they didn't have to necessarily interact with that voice assistant all the time. But it's going to extend capabilities within Android devices, with you having the ability to create icons or widgets that start activities, routines, really anything that the Google Assistant can do. And I think this is going to be extremely powerful for us. As we see Google Assistant get more and more integrated into the base level of Android. Now, earlier in the video, I talked about that October 15th event, and I'm really excited about it. And to be honest, I think you should be too. I think Google has a ton in store for us there, and it's going to be a very interesting event. Now, part and parcel to all of this is I've seen a number of sales on Google Wi-Fi, Google Home Mini devices, and I think you gotta watch yourself a little bit. So I would really recommend that you go watch the video that's on screen right now that tells you what to expect on October 15th from Google. Now, otherwise, guys, I hope this video has really got you excited about this ecosystem again. And until next time, thanks for watching, and don't hate, automate.